Hey team, today we are talking about exercises that increase the strength and endurance of your rotator cuff. So your rotator cuffs pretty much prevents your shoulder from injury, keeps it nice and stable and safe in your pressing and overhead movements, also your abduction, so like your lateral raises of your shoulder. So our first exercise is a external rotation press with a resistance band. So you're going to grab your resistance band and tie it to a low point on a rack or a pole. Get into a lunge position, and what you're going to do, you're going to initiate the movement with a row, keeping that elbow at 90 degrees. Then you're going to externally rotate. So as I hear, I externally rotate. Then you're going to press, just like that, keeping that shoulder nice and stable. Maybe at first the press is a little bit advanced, so you're going to just start with that row and external rotation with a hold for 5 seconds, and as you progress, you can add that press at the end, as I do here. Awesome. So our next exercise, guys, is a lying external rotation. So you're going to grab a plate, you're going to hop on your side, and you're going to roll up a towel and put it under your armpit. All that does is just put your shoulder in a nice position for this exercise. You're going to roll those shoulders back, and what you're going to do is just externally rotate. Try not to roll the shoulders back or forward as you go through this movement. Keep those shoulder blades retracted and just externally rotate with that arm. You should feel a good burn in this one. Your next one is a TheraBand W. So you're going to do the exact same movement, but what you're going to do is you're going to hold that band right here for 5 to 10 seconds for 15 to 20 reps or so. You're going to really feel the burn with this one. Again, try and keep those shoulder blades retracted. Have a nice posture throughout the whole movement. And try and keep those elbows at 90 degrees, not above or below. And as I said, hold that band, squeeze 5 to 10 seconds, then repeat. In our last exercise, guys, you're going to grab, again, two small plates, and we're going to go through our raises. But with this one, we're going to add pretty much static hold. You can do this one in a number of ways. So the first one I'm showing you guys is kind of like a front raise with a static hold with one arm and going through repetitions with the other arm. So maybe 5 to 10 reps on one arm while the other arm is in a static hold. Then switch once you finish those reps. In this version I'm showing you is kind of like a 45 degree angle one. So you can do this version where you just hold at the top and go for your repetitions. What you can also do is hold one in a static hold, then rep it out with the other arm, maybe 5 to 10 reps, then switch arms and have that static hold in the other arm. So the point of this one, guys, is just to incorporate that static hold, going for the movement quite slowly and making sure that shoulder is nice and stable. And they are going to strengthen your rotator cuff, guys. Hope you enjoyed.